Right, well, otherwise what I'll do is I'm taking you straight to the cross.
Never swallowed it.
They were all right here.
Da da da. Are buckled up. He You'll find a full listing of all audio and video programming. You'll find that in the seat pocket in front of you. We will be coming through during the flight sometime, distributing the documentation needed. And you should have that filled out and available as you go through the customs and immigration procedures. We do invite you now to sit back, relax, and enjoy the flight. If there's anything we can do to make you more comfortable or to help you in any way, don't hesitate to call on us.
Here fuss about. The tape was accidentally erased 9 times. Could happen. Like Germany accidentally invaded Poland twice. You know, it could happen. I want to tell you, let me put it this way. We got about as much chance of finding out what's on those tapes as we do of seeing Howard Hughes guest starring on Celebrity Bowling.
Sleep.
That's not true.
They didn't tell me they were going to change it.
I understand John is not with us anymore.
Don't say that. Now, Tommy Newsom is going to do something this coming, well, not this coming weekend, but the weekend following this weekend. Tommy Newsom is giving a concert and a clinic. And after his concert, you'll have to go to a clinic, you know, at the University of Wisconsin in Green Bay on the 26th of January. How about it? I understand the concert part, right? You play, so what? What's the clinic? What do you know the clinic?
Well, they hope to have it cleared up in 2 or 3
I know that. The people might be interested. I'm asking a legitimate question. You said for the students to talk about music and technique and so forth as in a clinic?
I've never been to one before either.
The students are certainly in for a wonderful one. What would he do? What would he do at a clinic?
He'll get up and either lecture on whatever subject that he chooses at that moment. Probably he'll lecture on what is Johnny Carson really like.
Oh, come on now. Clinic is...
No, a clinic.
Eddie Shaughnessy goes and has clinics with the drummers and they sit around and...
I would get up and talk about trumpet playing.
Good.
Tommy would get up and talk about dogs. Now, you know, that we kid Tommy a lot about
it. And he certainly deserves it.
Actually, I'm going to talk about how to find peace through death.
Tommy's gone through all of that, so he knows. This is really a reincarnation here. Talk about his instrument, right?
So, oh, yes, he's going to do that, all right. In the motel.
Oh, come on now. Man's trying to conduct a serious show and pass on some knowledge for our viewers, and you two clowns. Sit here. Okay, anyway, he's going to be back in Green Bay, which is probably lovely there this time of year. Why couldn't you get a clinic in Florida or someplace or Palm Springs? You've got to go to Green Bay. That makes sense. The September clinic for it in Death Valley that he walks across. He and 30 musicians try to walk across Death Valley.
You know, as much as we can, Tommy.
Yes.
He writes really some of the most colorful and passionate music that we have in our position.
That's true. Tommy does a lot of the charts for the orchestra.
Yeah.
And that in itself is
really
like
great music.
Unique. Should have been put away years ago. Okay, I've got some odds and ends here. You get these things in the mail at home. Somehow in this country you get on mailing lists. You know, there are companies that sell your name and address to all kinds of companies around the country, and you get on the mailing list where they send you the contest gimmick that's going on. The various companies, you could be a grand sweepstakes winner. Do you get those all the time? In your mailbox, dear Mr. and Mrs. Klarn, you are lucky you. You are one of the sweepstakes winners. Mail this certificate in and so forth. Gentleman sent me one that he had entered a contest. His name is Walter W-O-L-A-N-S-K-I, Walanska, I believe. And he entered, and he got a letter from the Reader's Digest, and he was notified that he was a sweepstakes winner. Remember that, it's always a sweepstakes winner. And his check was in the mail. He sent me the check. I want to show you. First of all, I got his name. Can we get a close-up? First of all, they sent it to Mr. Wolanski instead of Wolanski. Misspelled his name. He lives in Lindenhurst, New York, and here is his wonderful sweepstakes winner. $0.10. True. Now, I'm not making this up. He got a 10-cent check as one of the sweepstakes winners. Isn't that a lovely contest? Had to buy the magazine. What's the magazine sell for? Half a buck and 8 cents postage. He lost 48 cents on that deal. Isn't that something? I guess he's a winner. He's got the check here. Now, I don't know what to do with the check. Here's an item. You know, if you think you've got an energy crisis here, London and the countries, England and the Holland, really, that countries, they've got problems. Of course, they have countries. It's a picture of the girls that work over there in the club. Well, they're strippers.
exceptions to that?
Yes, there are. You're in a terrible mood tonight. Did you know that the Coast Guard's men and women now share the same bathrooms? They had a problem. They took women in the Coast Guard. They took women into the Coast Guard, and they said it required too much money to build a... As they say in the Navy, it's the head, right? So now they share the same bathrooms. What are you giggling at? He thought of something terrible again.
Yeah, I just saw the sign on the door. His and his.
not poor, not.
Well, I think so.
Just to see what it would be like. morning. You see, guys with accents always have it, and it helps a little bit, don't they? Because the average woman thinks if a fella has an accent, it's French, Spanish, or whatever, is somehow mysterious and has more emotional qualities.
You know, some of the accents are very never thought of that. I always say I didn't say
that. I didn't mean that.
Control it as well.
But I had to learn to control it.
Right. Well, you have to. As you went, you were under orders.
some dudes really get weird and want to fight women. Right, they always want to fight the women, right, guy?
Say, man, what you mean we can have another drink? Well, we gonna spend money all night, tell me, don't hold me, man. Give me a drink, man. You never get a beer in front of house. What? Woo! What's wrong with you, fucking woman?
jump up at me. Remember? You jump up, you'll have to catch up. You were fuzzy cute.
I like Bob Steele.
Bob Steele? Bob Steele was in the movie once. He saw on television, man. I don't know if he was high or what, but it looked like... No, it looked like Bob Steele said to him. It was white. It looked like Bob Steele said, like, no.
Did you not
end it so much?
station. And it's because the viewers, some viewers are frightened, but it's touching. And I wonder how often that nerve is the realization that the horror on that screen, that demon, is the ultimate father to, the ultimate blood relation to, and the ultimate destiny of cheating your brother and calling it business. I think that's what it comes down to. But I'm happy about it. I mean, we have the smelling salts. We have handy all the time. I'm sorry that some people don't. I'm glad because it's done what it's supposed to do.
It is a wonder, but I found the interesting thing about it, as you say, when you see it in a group of people, you find out that people are affected by different things. Where some people will see a particular scene that might be physically unpleasant, that doesn't bother some people, but the language of the young girl, which she uses, upsets them tremendously.
Well, they see
different things. It is upsetting, but the grown people will have different reactions. What they see is horrifying or obscene.
I myself, excuse me.
I'm sorry. Did the pitch have any effect in the world after?
No.
Is the girl all right?
The girl is so psychologically sturdy.
She's okay.
I think that was kind of how that
I read that book before you went to the French, and Lord Marshall gave it to me.
Oh, yes.
With your typewriter. And it was a thing like this. And I said, where are they going to get this car? And what is going to happen? Getting involved in this thing.
Fernanda, she giggled after every take. I mean, the whole procedure. And you know what it is. You're surrounded by 80 technicians like Cape Canaveral.
Yeah, people forget that. I almost, watching the picture sometime, had to say, no, wait a minute. I know that you're standing around, and the prop men are doing these things to get my own mind away from what's going on, almost to bring it back to reality.
I'm almost a very religious view.
So a lot of people said that there is
the Catholic Church is the official Christ.
Sounded like a CIA movie.
the sign on the article says that it is so rare, you know, one absolutely of it. And there, to my knowledge, in the center, are only three exorcisms. I did bring along a,
what's this piece of tape with?
A piece of tape. The quality is very bad because it was not done professionally. A portion of an exorcism performed in Rome about 5 years ago by an incident.
So this is not a study, I mean, this is not accurate or anything?
No. This is an actual, the exorcism took several months.
Was this for a person? Because they also do it for buildings, I understand. Exercise
slurs, yeah. Exorcism of the place. But this was of a person. I'll talk about the person after you for a moment. As I said, I know nothing.